A while ago, someone asked me to create a tutorial for the workflow I use when I'm creating quick maps, and, well, obviously this has piqued my interest considering I've made this video. I've put all the links to the software that you'll need in the description down below. So without further ado, let's go! Start by creating a landform. I'm working with a vector program, but your program of choice doesn't actually matter. When you're done with it, save it. Open up the landform in a program where you can work with rasters. In my case, it's Photoshop. Make sure that the background is true black, whilst the landmass is somewhat of a dark gray. This is because we're creating a height map, and the brighter the color, the higher the landmass. Use some brushes. There are plenty of good options in the basic programs, such as GIMP and Photoshop, but I've made some custom ones that you can find in the description. Start off by painting a rough height map using different layers of opacity. Then move on to work with some details by masking out random bits using the same brushes. When exporting this image, it's very important to remember that the size will impact rendering times in our next step. I'd recommend no more than 3000 pixels in any axis. Next, open up the image in Wilbur. Select from terrain, starting at the value of 0.2 to 10,000. I usually start with 3 erosion cycles, with the settings currently on screen. I follow this up with 2 cycles of erosion cycle, incise flow, and precipitation. You can repeat this process as many times as you'd like. More does not, however, equal better. Here I am showing you my settings once again. When you're finished rendering, save the results as a 16-bit image. Let's open this image in GIMP and use the map filter. You can tweak the settings to your liking and then export. The results should look something like this. Here I am working in Photoshop, but I suppose you can replicate this process in programs such as GIMP as well. I've imported both the height map and the bump map and made sure that the entire file is set to RGB color mode. I then set the bump map's blending mode to linear burn. You can change the opacity of this layer to get a desired result as well. Then I use a gradient filter to add colors. This can either be chosen from the window you see right now, or you can copy the colors from your style sheet. The result should look something like this. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you'd like a slower version where I go into every nook and cranny and explain more, and perhaps even show you how to create brushes, make sure to leave a comment and like the video. If you're a fellow Redditor neckbeard, such as myself, you can always find more of my work over there. Cheerio, nerds!